New year, same old, same old. The Harry and Meghan circus rumbles on, as it will until the money and publicity run out, which could take a while. Which means we'll hear more revelations, more scandal and more accusations. But we'll get fed up. It already feels like we are near the bottom of the barrel. We get that Harry has the right to tell his story. We get he feels hard done by, slighted, out in the cold. And that's fine. Everyone has a right to tell their truth. But in continually mining his past for tragedy, Harry is doing incalculable damage. In his latest revelations, he talks about the death of his mother. Of course, this is a subject that has shaped his life, how could it not? Harry talks about the trauma. A trauma so shocking he could hardly cry, such was the depth of his grief. A trauma so devastating it tore his family apart. But surely he must realize what he is doing now. More trauma. Wounds reopened, fresh feuds, bitter divides. He knows the pain of the family destroyed by grief. This doesn't feel like catharsis anymore. It feels like a deliberate attack on his father, his brother. Harry got what he wanted. He felt trapped by the institution of the royal family. Now has free. He has money, unimaginable prestige, a wife and family. He has an incredible platform to do good. Instead has turned inward. Lashing out, flogging painful memories for all they are worth. The book and the interview have been too much, but they should be enough. His grievances are aired, ghosts laid to rest, scores settled. Damage done. Time to stop. The NHS was born 75 years ago and Professor Harold Ellis was there, 22, fresh out of medical school and proud to join. Now 96, he has seen a lack of funding plunge it into crisis. He asked Rishi Sunak, "What on earth has happened to my beloved NHS? The Tories, that's what. Unless a radical solution is found, its 75th year could be the last in the spirit in which it was founded. Publicly funded and free to all, our proudest achievement."